Hey everyone, and welcome to the sixth video in the series in which we examine the life cycle of writing and deploying a Chialisp smart coin. In this video, we are going to be moving forward with the applications surrounding the piggy bank coin that we have built over the course of the last five videos. If you haven't seen any of those yet, I would recommend that you go back and watch those before you start here. Now that we've got the introduction out of the way, let's go ahead and talk about what we're going to be doing here. In this video, I'm going to be writing some Chialisp driver code. The reason that we write driver code after we write our puzzles is because our application is not going to be purely in Chialisp. Chialisp is an extremely versatile language for programming money, but it's not particularly great at making RPC calls and writing to databases. We're always going to have another language on top of our puzzles, but that being said, it won't always necessarily be Python, which is what I'm going to be doing the driver code in today. Our puzzles have to be in Chialisp, but our surrounding code can be whatever we want. There just happens to mostly be support for Python at the moment, since that's what the Chia fold node is implemented in, so that's what I'm going to be using here. I've already set up all of the imports that I'm going to be using when I'm writing this code, because I want to focus less on the specifics of the Python implementation and more on what good driver code should do. It's worth noting that if you are using Python, it's probably a good idea to take a look at some of the puzzle driver code in the Chia blockchain repository to get familiarized with where to import some of these objects from. All right. Let's go ahead and start writing some code. Good driver code should aim to be the only interface between your puzzle and the rest of your application. If any other part of your application is loading the Chialisp and doing things like currying to it, then if you decide to change the puzzle, you'll have to find every place that it's loaded and you'll have to change the code there too. You want the rest of your application to simply use the functions from this file so that there's only one place to update if you need to change anything about the puzzle. This driver code is going to be fairly simple because there's literally only two things we can do with our piggy bank coin. We can create it, and we can contribute to it. That's it. The puzzle handles what happens when we reach the savings goal, and it handles recreating itself after we've reached the goal. We don't have to worry about either of those things. So we're just going to have a driver for creating the piggy bank coin and a driver for contributing to the piggy bank coin. Let's go ahead and get those started here. So the first thing we need to do is we need to load our CLVM. We're going to do that by calling a function called loadCLVM. We're going to call piggybank.clisp, and then we're going to specify the package it's in, and our piggy bank coin happens to be, because it's one of the examples that we have in the dev tools, it's going to be in CDV examples CLSP. If you're doing this in your own project, what you're going to want to do is you want to make sure that your project folder is a Python package by adding in a NitPy file in here. And then you're going to go ahead and specify that it's in the folder piggy bank. But for right now, I'm just going to use the CDV one. All right. So we need to create a piggy bank. And we need to generate a solution to contribute to a piggy bank. All right. Let's go ahead and work on this first one. This driver code is going to be one line. It's going to be very simple. It's going to be a function, create piggy bank puzzle, and we're going to specify an amount and a cash out puzzle hash. You'll recognize these as the arguments that we curry into our puzzle. This is a very common type of driver, which will just handle all of the currying for you. You pass the function whatever values you want to use in your puzzle, and the driver code takes care of actually constructing it for you. We're going to go ahead and return the puzzle, which is piggy bank mod dot curry amount and cash out puzzle hash. And that's it. That's our entire driver code. What this is going to do, we're going to pass it an amount and a cash out puzzle hash, and it's going to return us the curried version of the puzzle. It'll return it to us as a program object that I have imported up here, and we can call all sorts of methods like get tree hash and stuff like that from our application. Next, let's go ahead and make the generate a solution for a piggy bank coin driver. Solution for piggy bank coin and contribution amount. Now, you may notice that I'm using something a little bit different than our current solution. What I'm doing is I'm passing it the coin that we're spending because it can extract the amount and the puzzle hash from that coin, but I'm also passing it contribution amount rather than new amount. The reason that I'm doing this is because I think it's a little bit more intuitive than new amount. The reason that I didn't do this as part of the Chialisp puzzle is for purposes of optimization. when you use new amount, the piggy bank coin can just create to the new amount. It doesn't have to worry about it. If we use contribution amount, it can add contribution amount to my amount, but that's an extra calculation. And when you have extra calculations in your Chialisp puzzles, that's going to incur cost. And so you want to defer as much calculation to outside the Chialisp puzzle as possible. So this driver code is going to create a very simple solution for us, but we are going to have to do one minor calculation in which we add the contribution amount to the current amount of the coin. Let me go ahead and write that. It's also going to be one line. Return program that to. In Python, this is how we do Chialisp pseudocode in Python. Piggy bank coin puzzle hash. Piggy bank coin amount. And in parentheses here, we're going to do piggy bank coin that amount plus contribution amount. And that's it. You'll notice that we put all of these arguments into an array here, a list. And the reason is because when we do program.to, it takes a very special syntax where a list means like a list in Chialisp, like parentheses, L-I-S-T, list. And if you wanted to do a con box, that would be a parenthesis with two values in it, first and rest. But we didn't need that for this because we're just doing a solution, which is just going to be a list of three things, the puzzle hash, the amount, and the contribution amount. I did realize that I did these in the wrong order. I think the puzzle hash is at the end here, so let me go ahead and fix that. Now, these are the two drivers that I mentioned, but I do actually want to include one more driver. This driver is sort of peripheral to the piggy bank, but it is specific to doing a piggy bank spend. And that is, I want to have a driver that gives the assertion of the announcement that the piggy bank creates. The reason that I want this is because we're going to have a standard puzzle or whatever that's going to do its own spend independent of the piggy bank coin, and it needs to assert our piggy bank coin so that we can make sure that our whole puzzle is secure, if you remember going over that from the security video. We don't want to have the standard puzzle figure this out, and we don't want to have to do piggy bank things outside of this driver code. So we're just going to add this function in that is return the condition to assert the announcement. We're going to call this piggy bank announcement assertion. Piggy bank coin contribution amount. You'll notice that this is getting the same arguments as our above driver here, solution for piggy bank. And the reason is because, again, this is happening at the same time that we're spending our piggy bank. So the only information about the whole spend that this piggy bank needs to know is what the coin that is being spent is and the contribution amount. Now, if you remember our announcement, I can pull it up for you here. We create an announcement of our new amount. Now, whenever we create a coin announcement, what it's going to do is it's actually going to hash our coin ID with the message that we are sending so that we can't be confused for any other coin making this message. This announcement is coming from us and not from anybody else. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and return a list here. Remember, this is a condition. It would just be like LISP here. We go ahead and return a list and condition opcode.assert coin announcement. And then again, the assertion is going to be the hash of the coin ID with the message that we are announcing, which in this case is new amount. So I'm going to go ahead and do standard hash piggy bank coin.name. Name is the same thing. It's going to be the hash of the amount, the parent coin info, and the puzzle hash. And then we're going to add, but this is bytes, so we're going to be concatting them. And we're using a special int to bytes function from CLVM so that we make sure that this is being interpreted properly as bytes rather than a integer string or anything like that. Int to bytes. And we're going to pass in the piggy bank coin amount. Same thing as up here. We can just go ahead and copy it. And that's it. This is the assertion of the coin announcement. So all the standard transaction or whatever it is going to have to do is going to have to add this condition to the list of conditions that it outputs. If it does that, it will be tied to the piggy bank coin in a way that if this spend gets separated from the piggy bank coin will still be valid and go up in value. And so someone will have to contribute to it for it to be valid because we can't just print money. But this is all the drivers that we're going to do. It's a very simple piece of driver code because it's a very simple coin. For more complex coins, you're probably going to have lots more drivers in here that are doing very specific things with the coin. But in general, you should try to keep it as simple as possible. But remember that the most important thing is that this is the only place that your application touches your puzzle. You don't want to call load CLVM piggy bank outside of this driver code. You don't want it in any of the other parts of the application. That's going to be it for this video. In the next video, we're going to be talking about testing your coins so that we can make sure that they're doing exactly what we want them to do over their life cycle. If you have any questions in the meantime, feel free to visit us on the Chialisp channel on Keybase. And until then, I will see you guys in the next video.